A very good morning, class 12. This is your subject physical education and we will be continuing with chapter number 10. Name of the chapter is training in sports and this is our lecture number 7. This is the very last lecture of your chapter number 10. And in this lecture we are going to discuss about circuit training method. We'll be talking about the meaning definition of circuit training method. We'll be discussing about the different types of circuit training. Okay. Its advantages, disadvantages, and what are the importance of performing circuit training. So starting with the definition and who invented circuit training. So it was invented by G.T. Adamson. And R.E. Morgan, okay, in the year 1957. Okay, so these both were the one who started circuit training method. So it is a training method, okay. It is a scientific and planned method in which we develop our strength and endurance. So it is a training method in which the definition is a training method. Okay. In which certain exercises of various kind are performed with or without equipment. So these are the training method, or it is the training method in which the certain exercises of various or different kinds are performed together, and it can be performed with or without apparatus. As I said, it is usually helpful in developing our strength and endurance. Okay. Now moving towards the types of circuit training method. So there are basically four types of circuit training methods. The very first one is the timed circuit training, and timed circuit training means it depends on the duration of the whole circuit. Okay. So the very important thing is that the whole session, the whole workout will be depending on the duration. So the duration of your rest period and workout period will be fixed, so it will not change. Like for example, if you are performing an exercise in a circuit for 1 minute. Okay, so this is your workout timing, and then you are going to take a rest. Take rest for again 1 minute, and then again shifting towards the next exercise. It will be for 1 minute workout. Okay, and then 1 minute rest. It can be anything. It can be 30 seconds, 45 seconds. So it can be anything. So, but the duration in this will be same. It will not change. Now moving towards the next one, which is competition circuit training. Okay. Now it is also kind of similar to the timed, similar to timed circuit training. Okay, but here the only difference is the individual, those who all are performing this circuit training, are going to compete with one another, right? So there will be a kind of competition between people. Now again, taking the same example, okay, taking the same example, if we were doing it for 1 minute, so it might be like an individual who is A is performing around 30 sit-ups, right? When we were talking about the time. Now, if we are talking about, this is the timed one, okay? When we are talking about the competition, obviously now because there is a sense of competition, you need to compete with the other players, those who are practicing with you in this training method. And then what will happen, then A is going to perform 45. It will be more than 30. That is what they are trying to say. In the same way, if there is B, C, D and other people also. So in competition, because it is like at the time one, there is no competition. You can perform easily also. Intensity can be medium or low. So obviously one can perform like he or she is performing 40. So when it will be like the competition one, then they will be increasing it. They might also reach 50 or 60 also. So in time, in competition, the only difference is that because it will be more like a competition between people or the players who are performing it, so they are going to put up their best while performing this circuit training. Okay, what was the second one? The third is our repetition circuit training. Okay, so in repetition circuit training, it is much more beneficial, you can say appropriate, or it can be more beneficial to the people, those whose physical fitness is more. So beneficial for players who have good physical fitness. So if an individual is having good physical fitness, he or she can perform according to his or her own capability, right? So when we talk about repetition, if someone is a player who is, a professional player, you can say, or a player who is not exactly new to the game and sports, and his or her physical fitness is very good, then he or she can perform. You can ask that individual that you have to perform 40 repetitions of sit-ups, right? For example. Right, in circuit A, in A place, and then you are saying that you have to do 30 push-ups. Okay, now if an individual, this is for an individual who is into games and sport for a longer period of time, whose physical fitness is good. Okay, now to someone who is just a beginner. Okay. Now what you can do is, you will ask them to do 15 repetitions of sit-ups, okay, 10 repetitions of push-ups. So it it is like kind of based on the repetitions, that these many repetition an individual has to do. So it can be like a pre-planned thing, that when you already know that there is an individual who is working out for a longer period of time and do have a very good physical fitness, then you may ask that individual to go for maximum number of repetitions. And an individual who is just beginner, who has just started performing activities, or just started the working out sessions, so you can ask them to have lesser number of repetitions according to their own capability. Okay, the last and the fourth type of circuit training is sport specific or running circuit training. These kind of circuit training is usually done in the larger area. You can use a 200 meters or a 400 meter track to perform it, right? And in this particular specific exercise of different games and sports are performed. If you are from cricket, then the exercises which are mostly done by cricketers, those kind of exercise would be performed in this kind of a circuit training. Or if you are from track and field, or if you are from football, volleyball, any whatever game an individual is performing, so specific game exercises will be there. Okay, next thing which you need to keep in mind, that instead of having a 30 seconds or a 1 minute rest, there will be slow jogging or walking in between of the exercises. So there will be slow walking or jogging between exercises. Now, before moving towards the, the advantages, disadvantages and the importance, I'm just making a circuit training whole. So a circuit training method can be, you can see it, that there will be a circle or any particularly a different shape it can be. There will be different stations, right? It will be like station 1, A, B, C, D. Right, so they can be as many as number you want to keep. It can be 8, 10, 12, 15, it can be any number of the stations. Now each and every station is going to have a particular exercise, so each and every station is going to have a particular exercise. I'm just writing it so that it will be easier for you. So it can be any kind of activity, any kind of exercise, and it will be for each and every station. Now, second thing which you need to keep in mind, that yes, if you are performing any activity of your upper body, so it will be, it is like something which is important, that in the next circuit, in the next station, you will be doing any exercise which is related to your lower body. You can even divide the exercises according to the body parts. For example, if you are performing the exercise for biceps here, so you can here perform hamstring exercise. Okay, here you can perform abdomen exercise. Then here you can perform tricep exercise, right? So what exactly I'm trying to make you understand is that when you perform a particular body part exercise in one station, you need to give that body part some rest so that body part can be recovered, right? Before, again, like you, when you go back to the same station and you start doing your bicep curls or anything, so before reaching to that particular station again, by that time, that particular body part would be recovered. So, there will be less chances of getting injured or overuse of the muscle. So this is how you have to make this whole session of your circuit training, right? It can be any number. So any number of stations which are there. The examples I've given you, A, B, C, D, 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever. You can put cones in a circle. And when I was telling you about the very last type, which was the game or the sports specific or the running one. So in that what happens, we use the whole track in it, right? So what exactly happens now? What here it will be like a gap of around 1 to 2 meters or 3 meters, whatever it is. You don't have to run from one place to another. But when we talk about the running circuit training, so for example, if this is the whole track, this is the whole track, right? A 400 or a 200 meter track. Okay. Now here the stations will be made like this. The station A will be here, B, if you are making it at a 50-50 meters, C, D, E, F, G, H, like that. Now you can see that there will be around a gap of 40 to 50 meters in between every station which is there. So as I said that they will, at the time of your rest you have to walk or you have to run. So after finishing off, for example, if you have finished off your push-ups here, so you have to run to B. It can be slow jogging, running, whatever is instructed by the coach, and then you have to do sit-ups for example and then reaching. So here in between you are going to jog or run or walk, whatever it is. Okay, so this is how it is all done. Now moving towards the advantages of circuit training. Okay, so advantages are, first that it can be performed both indoor and outdoor, right? So there is no problem if you are performing it outdoor also, it can be performed indoor. Even if it is like raining outside, right, then also it can be performed indoor. The next advantage which is there, it is like equipments which are used in circuit training are easily available. Equipments are easily available. As I said, sometimes you don't need equipments for performing circuit training. Okay. Then it is very easy to learn. If you have learned the exercises, if you know your own capability, then a trainee or a player himself can train him or her into this kind of a training session. So it is very easy to learn. Fourth point says it shows you good results in short period. In a short period also, it is going to show you good results. Fifth point says that it is a very interesting method because it keeps on changing. It does not get very boring or it's not a monotonous kind of a thing. So, it is an interesting method. Okay. Sixth point says that no long duration is needed. Okay. You don't have to kind of doing the same exercise for a very longer period of time. So no long durations are there. So it can be done very easily in a short period also. So these are the advantages of your circuit training method. Moving towards the disadvantages. Okay. The very first disadvantage is that you need a lot of advanced planning or pre-planning is advanced planning is to be done. Because of that you will be requiring more time for planning each and everything, more time, and because you have to make the whole circuit. So obviously even if it is indoor, it is in a big hall, or even if you are performing it inside the gym, still you need a lot of space for performing that particular exercise. So a lot of time is required for both, for the planning also, and obviously so they have just total the timing which is required there. it is highly fatiguing, that if you are performing it and if you are someone new, right, so it is going to fatigue you, as because in between also you are not getting a lot of recovery period in between. You just need to perform it on a on a continuous kind of a basis, so it is very fatiguing. Okay, next point says that yes, it does help us in getting our muscles toned, but the size of muscle will not change. So if you want to increase the muscle size, so there will be no gain in muscle size. Okay, so these are the disadvantages. Now moving towards the characteristics of circuit training. Okay, so the characteristics of circuit training is that it is simple to learn and simple to execute. So it is something which is simple to learn. And simple to execute, so it can be done in a very simple way. Okay. Next characteristics is it does use just the medium resistance is used in this, so you just have to perform exercises or activity with your medium resistance, medium frequency, medium intensity, right? So medium weight or medium resistance is used. You can't use a very high level or a very high resistance because you need to perform all the exercises continuously. Okay. Number of repetitions can be more or less, it depends. So it can be number of repetitions to be more. Yes, more. Okay. Next point, that the main aim is to develop the endurance and strength. So one of the things that it develops endurance and strength. Next characteristics is that it, in this you can exercise the whole body, so whole body is exercised. And the last characteristic is it is normally done in the preparatory period. So these are the characteristics of the circuit training method. Now moving towards the importance. First importance is that you can get maximum result, right, in minimum time. As you can here, adjust the repetitions, the time of performing it, the recovery time, the time for both the your workout or your recovery. Okay, so it can be adjusted. So obviously you can adjust it according to what kind of a result you want and when you want it, right? So you can get the maximum result in minimum time, and as it can be adjusted, the number of exercises can also be adjusted. You can keep much more exercises to have a better improvement in a shorter period of time. So number of exercises which are there, or you can say the stations, the number of exercises can be increased, right? Okay, moving towards the next importance is your ideal for beginners. See, why it is ideal for beginners? Because it will make them more interested into games and sports, so it will make them more interested. Okay, it is going to enhance their endurance and strength both. endurance and strength. So both is both the components are both the components are enhanced. Okay. And it can also work as the basis of you know, the main basis of the whole games and sports. So it can also work as the basis of for other games and sports, preparing them for other games and sports. Okay. Next important is, it is very convenient. It can be done at any place, wherever you want to, with whatever reputation or with or without the equipments which are there. So it is something which is very convenient. Okay, so it is something which is very convenient to be done, as you can easily or by your own ways can adjust the timing. Adjust the timing, you can adjust the equipments. If you want some equipment, you don't want the equipments, whatever the requirement is there, you can do that. Again and again, the number of exercises can be changed. It can be very convenient because it can be performed indoor as well if it is raining outside, and outdoor as well. So wherever you want to perform it, it can be performed. So it is something which is very convenient for everyone. Okay. Next is, all the body parts can be exercised. Okay, so each and every body part can be exercised. Here it is how you plan the whole circuit training. So all the body parts can be exercised in this, right? As I have given you the example when I made that circuit, that I said that you can do it for bicep also, hamstring also, abdomen also, tricep also, quadriceps also. It can be for each and everything, for your sides also, for your back also. So all the body parts can be exercised. Next point is, says that cardio and strength training can be performed at the same time. So cardio, okay, and strength training, because it is continuously done, that is why because it is continuously done, so obviously the cardio is enhanced. And our strength is enhanced because we keep some kind of a resistance there, because there is resistance. So both can be enhanced, and both can be enhanced simultaneously. This is what the main point is. Okay, moving towards the next, many trainees can perform exercise at the same time. So large number of trainees can perform. If I have kept in a whole circuit, if I have kept 15 stations, those 15, there can be 15 students, those who are performing it, plus at each station I can also keep 2 to 3 training. So the large number of trainees can perform it. The next is, they say the amount of training can be, next is amount of training can be changed. So amount of training can be changed. Okay. Next point, no feeling of boredom. As I said, it will keep you interested, as the characteristics when we were talking about. So no boredom will be there. As it is not monotone, it keeps on changing. You can change the timing, you can change the exercises, you can change the duration, you can change the repetition, you can change the stations, you can change anything, all the things there. That is why there will be no boredom. And the last important is, it burns extra fat because you are continuously performing the exercises and the recovery period less. So you don't get time to recover and your body keeps on working out, right? That's why it burns extra fat. Okay. So this is the end. I'm moving towards the homework for this lecture. Question number one. Define circuit training. Explain any two types of circuit training. Question number three. Explain any three importance of circuit. Now the discussion of the questions which were given in your lecture number 6. Answer 1. The question number 1 was explain coordinative ability. So it is a stabilized and generalized patterns. Your motor control and regulation process of motor control and regulation process. Okay. Answer of the question number 2 was question 2 was explain the rhythm ability. So when you perform, okay, when you coordinate with the rhythm, the ability to perform activities, to perform movements, right, in a rhythm, okay, or you can say just moving according to the rhythm which is given to you, the observer, when you observe or how you perceive the rhythm and accordingly you perform movement, that is the ability of your rhythm. That is the rhythm ability. Third is balance ability. The question was explain balance ability. So the ability to maintain balance, okay, during, like when you perform any activity, during performing activities, okay, and it is also the ability of gaining balance if there is any balance disturbance. Okay, this is the answer. This is the end of your lecture. Thank you.